मैं कमिंग सो मॉर्निंग सो
दीप्ति, दीप्ति मुनाली, what is the meaning of your name, दीप्ति?
So Deepti means that which brings light to others people's lives.
Oh, I see. Deepti, you are very richly endowed academically. You have done MA in philosophy from an institute, a very prestigious institute called Miranda House,
yes,
Delhi University. Huh?
Yes,
who was Miranda? Why it is called Miranda House?
So actually, the then Vice Chancellor of Delhi University, Maurice Guare, his daughter was named Miranda.
Daughter?
Yes, sir, daughter. And apart from that, his favorite novel, The Tempest, which was written by Shakespeare, that novel has a very influential lady protagonist.
Okay.
She was also named Miranda. So, okay. Because of this.
Very good. Okay, Deepti, tell me, what is you have opted philosophy and you are MA, postgraduate in philosophy also.
Yes.
What is the utility of philosophy to human life?
So, actually, philosophy is a very fluid kind of subject, and that is very different from other disciplines because it does not offer a definitive answer to some questions. But when it comes to life or in terms of utility, we find that each and every individual is a philosopher in his own place because we try to make sense of every choices in our lives, and that exercise of making sense of things and in a bit more technical terms, logical reasoning, in those terms, it is helpful.
Okay. Human life is one thing, but public administration is another aspect of. So, how will you utilize your knowledge of philosophy in motivating your subordinates? Because the civil servants are generally very demotivated. How will you motivate your subordinates?
So in the as a proper discipline of philosophy, we come across many sub-disciplines such as political philosophy, ethics, and postmodernism, among other things. So what happens is that we get to have a very broad perspective on things. It becomes easy in that manner to promote our subordinates to give a broad picture, to understand their own experiences, to address their issues, okay. And in that manner.
What is your personal philosophy of life? Everybody must be having some. I don't have any philosophy, but what is your philosophy?
Okay, sir. So, in my personal opinion, philosophy is something which tries to address fundamental questions about everything and anything, like even as basic as whether this water bottle is real or not, or as ethereal as whether God exists or not. So in that terms.
Okay. You belong to Bihar. There was a caste survey or caste census carried out recently. Was it a survey or a census?
It's a caste survey.
Survey. What is the objective of this survey?
So the basic objective is to have a more data-driven policy making so that we can address the issue of the backwardness of certain classes. Because what happens that the categorization, such as of OBCs or SCs, STs, that has been driven by the previous surveys, which are old now. So to have more specific data driven so that the benefits can be made possible. To
do you support the idea of reservation? Yes. You support it?
Yes, sir, because so in an ideal world, there should not be any
See,
need
one
of
view is that reservation promotes mediocrity. It kills merit. That's one perception.
Yes, sir.
You don't agree with that?
Yes, sir. That is why I feel that in an ideal world, there should not be any place of reservation. But the issue is that we are not living in an ideal world.
Mm-hmm.
There have been historical injustice and there are communities which need some sort of support. And as far as the mediocrity is concerned, so what happens that when we assess someone's professional caliber, in that case, there is no such concession given to any community, whether that be in case of engineering or medical. So when the final labeling is put, such as someone's engineer or doctor or scientist, there is no such use of quota or reservation. It's only in terms of support for the enrollment sake. Hmm. After that, everybody has to prove his or her caliber.
Okay. The general perception about Bihar is that, you know, it is not developed to the extent it was expected. The healthcare system is very rickety, very weak. Educational system also is very weak.
Yes.
Is it because of funds crunch, resources crunch, or lack of will, political will?
Sir, this is true that the situation there in terms of health or education is not at par.
Mm-hmm.
But the reason can be traced to some of the historical background as well, because in the 1960s to 1980s there was a lot of political instability in the state. Yes. And after that the polity has evolved. Yes. Such that the focus is more on social justice, and in that case the caste factor comes into place, and so the political awareness of the voters is very lacking in that sense. And it is very difficult to hold accountable those political leaders. So, and apart from the lack of political will, which is there to some extent, the administrative inefficiency is also there, in terms of infrastructure or even in the implementation of the policies,
okay,
there are issues.
Okay, you have given IFS as your number two choice. Huh?
Yes.
So you have some passion for international affairs?
Yes, sir. I find it interesting.
It's very good. Why not any others? Why do you have passion for IFS?
Sir, passion might be a bit more strong term, but I do have interest in that sense, because I think that I don't know how to put it, but yes, I really.
Okay.
I have interest.
Because you have an opportunity to represent the country at international fora. That's one thing you can say. Achha, now, talking about international relations, war is going on between Palestine and Israel. What has been India's stand? India has remained neutral all through. India has not taken a stand, you know, clear stand. You know.
Mm-hmm. Sir, in that sense, I think at the beginning it was really a contentious issue that whether, because it was a terrorist attack on Israel. Mm-hmm. But later on, the way Israel has retaliated, India has indeed taken a decisive stance, even on international fora, that irrespective of the terrorist attacks, one cannot carry on such kind of humanitarian attack on the common people of Gaza.
Okay. One last question. Elections are due. General elections are due within a month or two. The freebies culture has again been revived. Are freebies legal or illegal?
So they are legal.
They are legal?
Yes, sir. There is no such constitutional provisions or legal provisions.
Okay, there is no constitutional provision. But what about the model code of conduct? Don't they violate this code?
Yes, sir. So in that period when MCC comes into play, when it is implemented, in that period one cannot offer such things or even start some major project issue.
It's the duty of the Election Commission to conduct elections in a free, fair and transparent manner. And it is not taking any action against parties, political parties, who are offering freebies to the voters. It is unethical. It may not have any provision in the constitution, but at least it violates the code of conduct ethically. You know, ethics is violated because it amounts to bribery. So what is your take on that, briefly?
Sir, freebies per se, that their ethical stance is determined by the intention by which they are offered. So if in general, when farm loans are waived off or when free bicycles or laptops are provided, they have their own utilities, especially in case of when bicycles or laptops are provided. But when it is provided, offered in when the elections approach, so I think I do agree that the bodies such as Election Commission and even the people, they should also be more. They should be critical of such stance because this is not a long-term solution to the issues.
Okay, thank you very much, Deepi. Please.
Well, Deepi, you have shown your interest in badminton. Can you name few of the Indian players who have come up to the international ranking?
Yes, sir. So, especially in the men's double team, Sattvik Sairaj and Chirag Shetty, they both are.
Okay, good. So, while doing NSS activities, which particular activity you liked most?
So, my main area was interacting with Divyangjan people. Mm-hmm. So, I used to help in making their assignments, recording books, and also in some fests which were organized in our colleges.
So, you have shown guided meditation. How guided meditation is different than other meditations?
Sir, actually in guided meditation, we take help of some audio visuals or binaural beats to help concentrate on our breathing.
All right. Okay. So, you also tried for combined defense services. What happened finally?
Sorry, sir?
You have written somewhere in your DAF that you tried for combined defense services. What happened finally? What happened? Could you join it, or you left it, or you could not join?
Sir, I cleared the stage one written 3 times, but the SSB schedules were such that every time
you could not opt for it. Okay. It no, disturbed sir, you.
No, sir. It was pandemic time, and every time there was some kind of lockdown or something, and my father is a bit aged, so I was more concerned for comorbidities and all. I thought that it is not a wise option too.
Is he okay now?
Yes, sir, he's fine, but that time it was more of a fear sort of thing.
All right. So, philosophy had been your optional. So, what are the major Indian schools?
Yes, sir. So, there are basically 9 schools which are divided into Astik and Nastik. So, those who follow the Vedic authority, they are called Astik, and those who don't...
Orthodox.
Yes, sir. And those who do not, they are called Nastik or Heterodox. The famous ones are Sankhya, Vaisheshika, Vedanta. And in the Heterodox, we have Jainism, Buddhism, Charvak.
So, Charvak is also a philosophy.
Yes, sir.
Few of the philosophers, they say it is not a philosophy.
Yes, sir, but that is where the beauty lies of philosophy, that even when one thinks that we don't have any philosophy, there is actually a philosophy hidden in that.
Okay. How our philosophy is different than the Western?
Sir, in Indian philosophy, there is a lot of focus on spiritual this moksha, we can say that. And there is that is more refined than the Western philosophy. Because in case of Western philosophy, there's more focus on mind, body, realism, idealism. But in case of Indian, we find that there is more dealings with the issues of human experiences. And that is why we have more refined concepts such as Atman, moksha, such kinds.
So, spirituality, you talk about the spirituality. How you define for a layman, if someone asks you that I want to attain I want to touch the spiritual height, how you will define it and develop the interest?
Okay, sir. So, for a layman, it is very, it is a convincing way to convince him that life is full of uncertainties. How much one plans his or her life, this is not necessary that things are going to turn out as per the plan. In the face of those uncertainties, I think the more a man is spiritual and has broad perspective, the more beautifully he can deal with the issues. And by way of personal experiences, interacting with him, I'm sure I can convince him.
what you understand by the word moksha?
Moksha.
In your philosophical terms.
So, sir, in Hindu tradition, rather in Indian tradition overall, we have this concept that there is a continuous cycle of birth and rebirth.
Hmm.
And the though the body dies and the body vanishes into the panch bhutas, but the Atman, that keeps on changing the bodies and goes through lives. And since the lives is full of suffering, so there is this concept of moksha, that when one attains the moksha, one escapes this vicious cycle of life and death.
Okay, Gita, is it part of a series of the Upanishad or not?
It is not Upanishad.
It is not Upanishad. So, in the Gita, how the moksha is described?
Sir, moksha is described in this sense only, because it also talks about the impermanence of the body and the permanence of the soul. And in that term only, it talks about that the way to attain moksha is the combination of bhakti yoga, karma yoga and jnana yoga.
Have you read Freud and Jung?
No, sir.
Okay. So, do you have any interest in the government schemes? Have you come across gamut of the government schemes recently? Have you read few of the schemes?
Yes, sir.
Can you name two schemes which have benefited you or your family?
Okay, sir. So the...
If not benefited, then you or your family, you had a touch of it. You might have come across.
Yes, sir. So the the digital payment system.
Digital payment UPI is one. Payment. Everybody is affected, yes, taking benefit of it, yes.
Yes, sir. Then the NEP policy 2020, that has cut out the MPhil program and that has made it not necessary post 2020. So I would like to say benefited, but yes, I didn't opt for MPhil further. After that, the PM Awas Yojana. In that, there is one component for middle class, and that gives this concession on interest. So my father has, in the past 3 years, so he has bought this one flat, and in that he has availed the benefit of that component.
The urban Yojana.
Yeah.
Okay, my last question is a situation. So you made a mention of the COVID. So we do not wish that such a situation should arise again. But by chance, the pneumonia and influenza, COVID-like situation in your city where you are posted as a district head has arisen. There is a shortage of the oxygen cylinders as well. The hospitals are, there is a fear that very soon hospitals will be full. How will you handle this situation?
So, sir, in that case, if the disease is communicable, then I will ensure a proper compartmentalization of the affected ones and the ones who are not affected. Apart from that, since there is a dearth of resources in the hospital as such, so I'll ensure that the whatever the basic medicines or the basic requirements such as masks that are available to the people at their places itself. Apart from that, since there is, since the need is such as of oxygen cylinders and something like that, for that I'll have to make contact with the senior administration and departments to ensure the availability of resources as soon as possible. And that's it.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, Dikti Monali. Why Monali? Who is Monali?
Sir, actually, my elder sister's name is Tripti Sonali.
Okay.
So she was very fond of having a rhyming name.
Okay, fine. Fine. You have actually volunteered at the Bianjang Fest, right?
Yes.
Can you tell me some government action the current government have taken, to benefit the Bianjang?
So, sir, there is first of all the basic statutory provision
law.
For them. And that ensures many benefits and most importantly, reservation also for them.
Yeah, 5%.
Yeah.
PWD Act 2006 in your name.
Yes, sir. Apart from that, there are many there are provisions for making the public infrastructure more accessible to them, such as ramps on the buildings, and even in the for example, in metro stations also we find such paths dedicated for them.
Yeah. So your optional was philosophy, and you have done a master's, right? And have you also enrolled for PhD?
No, sir, but I have cleared NetJRF.
Okay.
And I've been applying.
Are you seeking to enroll yourself as a
Yes.
As a PhD candidate?
Yes, sir.
And then further for teaching?
Yes, sir.
Then why you are appearing for this interview, sir, before UPSC?
Yes, sir. So that is also my interest, and I do feel that teaching is a very noble profession, and I have interest in my discipline as well. But the point is that civil services offers a more diverse roles, and that has more scope for my personal development as well. That is why I'm here.
Okay, fine. What is the philosophy? So, how one can define philosophy?
So, sir, philosophy is basically the study of fundamentals of everything and anything. So, it deals with reason, mind, language, God, world, cosmology.
Who is considered as a founder, you know, the father of philosophy or genesis of philosophy?
Yes, sir. So, in a systematic way, Plato is considered as the father of philosophy.
Is it Plato or his teacher, Socrates? Yes. Plato is called father of political philosophy rather than philosophy, and Socrates is considered as a
father
of philosophy in the Western, you know, in the Western, you know, society. But what about India?
Sir, in case of India, the Vedas, I think, are the main authority, because they only have this, they have provided this basis, and the ones who are following that, they are called, again, orthodox, and
right.
They are the main, because there are six schools under the orthodox, and there are rest three in the...
You must have gone through Socrates' teaching, right? And you have also gone through Buddhist teaching, right? I find, you know, the Buddhist teaching is more righteousness, right, rather than the Socrates. But why Socrates is known as a father of philosophy, not Buddha? Although Buddha was earlier than Socrates.
Yes, sir. Actually, the thing is, this is a result of Western hegemony, even on the disciplines as well.
Hmm.
And that is why Socrates is more worldwide considered as the father of philosophy.
Very good. Very good. This is a Western imposition on us, that we are considering Socrates as a, you know, father of philosophy.
I would not deny his wisdom and the knowledge, but it's just that as you compared him with the Buddha also, so I don't think that Buddha, because I really feel that the Indian philosophy is more enriching, and since it is more older than the Western Western thinkers, so I do think that more credit should be given to the Indian philosophy.
Fine. I was just comparing Socrates because he was also for righteousness, right conduct, right? And that he developed, you know, the entire philosophy, although philosophers earlier. Anyway, if you see, you know, I was talking about, have you heard about gender inequality report? What is India's place?
Sorry, sir, I cannot recall the exact ranking, but I know that it is not at par where it should be.
Okay, fine. So, you must have gone through the gender issues, right? As a woman and, you know, you must have some concern about the woman as a social group. If you look at woman as a social group, in which area woman lacks, you know, access?
Sir,
should I give you four options?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, political empowerment, economic opportunity, health, and educational attainment.
So I think all the four options are true. But in my opinion, the economic opportunities, that is the main hurdle.
Still, women are lacking.
Yes, sir.
Fine. You must have heard about, 26th January, on Kartavyapath, there is a tableau of different, states and different, you know, theme. There was a tableau on this 26th January, Nari Shakti. Have you heard of Nari Shakti mission of the Government of India?
Yes, sir.
What are the dimensions?
Sir, it was more about the empowerment of women in terms of increased access to health education and employment.
Now 40%, you know, presence of personnel, I think, at the Kartavyapath was women, you know, regarding police, regarding military, regarding others, right? So you must focus on the Nari Shakti, you know, how government, and what are the, do you know dimensions of Nari Shakti mission? No? Are you aware about Nari Shakti Adhiniyam, na? Abhinandan, Nari Shakti, Samta Adhiniyam Abhinandan. The Roman Woman Reservation Bill recently passed by the government.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What it is?
Sir, it is about the 33% reservation for women in parliament.
Nari Shakti Abhinandan Adhiniyam, something. You know, government makes close, so known in Hindi. Right. You must have heard about, you know, the South Africa allegation of Israel. And recently, International Court of Justice have directed Israel to stop genocide. Is it this direction given by International Court of Justice is binding?
Yes, sir, it is binding, but...
Go ahead.
Okay, sir, but since there is no implementing body as such, so generally its orders are not followed, as was seen in the case of Russia-Ukraine war as well.
Fine. What do you know about postmodernism, and how can you relate postmodernism to Indian context? Has it entered in India?
Yes, sir. So postmodernism basically means that since the concepts such as rationality, reason, all of them have arisen from the Western domain, and they are imposed on the non-Western academia or on people. So what happens, it was more of a top-down approach, that if man is supposed to be rational, then each and every man is understood in that term only. So postmodernism was developed as a reaction to such an approach, and it focuses more on the reason of each and every person. So it was more of a bottom to top approach. And as far as its entrance in Indian context is concerned, so yes, there are many in sub-disciplines also we find such ideas, such as in political philosophy we have this idea of subalterns. Then in feminists also we have many Indian feminists such as Uma Narayan, and she has brought forth this idea that if there is feminism, so the feminism which we study from in the perspective of Western domain, that is very much different from what the need of Indian women are.
So okay, that is intersectionality approach that,
yes,
you are talking about,
yes.
right? Okay, fine. You know, what do you think about yourself? Are you postmodern or modern or still, you know, a mix of feudal, modern and postmodern?
So, I think I am a modernist and trying to go towards the postmodernist. So, it is a conflicting situation, because the ideals such as liberty, equality, democracy, these are very much real and needed in that sense. But to adjust them in the Indian context, that has to be tricky. And that is why it's a learning process for me.
Yeah. Look at, you know, Indian government, which, you know, giving ration to the 80 crore people, right? Under the Pradhan Mantri Jan Garib Kalyan Yojana. But recently, if you look at Niti Aayog, which has published a report, and India, you know, witnessed reduction in poverty, you know, from 26 to 11%. Don't you think it is a contradictory?
So the context in which this scheme was introduced was the pandemic time, and it was very much needed at that time. And the fact that it is continuing shows the good intent of the government of India to help the people. And apart from that, it is true that on the data level the poverty has decreased, but of course in terms of the need of the welfare measures,
Fine. There is a last question. What do you find the relationship between soul and body if we compare Indian philosophy and Western philosophy?
So, sir, in Indian philosophy, there is not much focus on soul. Rather, that idea of soul can be compared with the mind. So, they have this mind-body relation, and in that, there are many sub-disciplines. So that can be understood as such as a sailor in a ship. So mind is in a body, like that case. But in case of Indian philosophy, it is more refined. And the Atman is very much different from the body. So the every experiences and the pain, pleasure, everything that is attributed to the body, whereas soul is something very much indifferent from all of these things.
Fine. From me, done from my side, Dr. Jitendra will ask you a question.
Hello, Dipti.
Hello.
So you are from Eastern Paran, right?
Yes, sir.
Motihari is a place from where Gandhi is famous. Okay, and you have studied from DAV school, Patna.
Yes, sir.
Right. So tell me something about why there was a separation in Arya Samaj movement.
So, because since Shraddhanand, Swami Shraddhanand, he was more willing to provide this education to the boys, and he was more inclined towards the traditional system, whereas Mahatma Hansraj was more inclined towards having a proper synthesis of both English education as well as the Indian, and he was also willing to provide the education services to both girls and boys.
That so separation happened in the lifetime of Dayananda Saraswati or after his death?
No, sir, after his death.
After his death?
Yes.
So what was the other means of separation apart from education?
Sir, as far as I know, it was for education and for this distinction of only co-ed education or boys education.
No food habit?
Yes, sir, there was.
What was the food habit?
Sir, because one section wanted to have proper vegetarianism.
Which one?
That is, I'm not
sure. DAV? They wanted non-veg or veg? Meat eating is supported by Hansraj. And DAV group supported the DAP, that's why I asked you. So DAV group, Hansraj and all, supported meat eating, you know? Where the other group was not supporting meat eating, they wanted to be proper vegetarians. It happened in the 1893 onwards, okay? So, and then later on, you studied your graduation from Daulat Ram College, right? And then Master in Mirinda House. So why did you change your college? Was there any difference in education in between both colleges?
Yes, sir, there was, and Miranda House has been taking rank 1 in the NIRF rankings for the past 6 to 7 years. And in my personal opinion, there was indeed kind of
I will learn something from Miranda House.
Yes, sir.
I will learn something from Miranda House, because you must not have been taught in Miranda House.
No, sir. It was the common classes in the arts faculty.
In the department. So why yes, did you sir. Choose?
Yes, sir. Because again, the environment was nice. The administration was very friendly.
As compared to Miranda. All right. Are there any college in Delhi University who are related to DAV philosophy, Arya Samaj philosophy? Can you name some college in Delhi University?
Sorry, sir, I can't.
College, Hansraj College.
These are the colleges of Delhi University.
Which are from your college?
Which are from that philosophy, hai na? Arya Samaj philosophy ke colleges, sab, theek hai? All right. So let us go to Bihar, hai na? So in 1917, Gandhi had went to Bihar, okay? So he was approached by Rajkumar Sukla. He was a rich peasant there, at, okay? So tell me, who was the other national leader who was firstly approached by Rajkumar Sukla to come to Bihar before Gandhi, and he refused to go to Bihar?
Sir, there was Rajendra Prasad.
He was from Bihar only, he was not approached. Rajendra Prasad was not a big leader in 1917. Tilak. So Tilak was firstly approached in Lucknow, and then he refused to go to Bihar, because Bihar, the Champaran issue, the 30th Islam, was a very small issue for him. Okay. Even Gandhi had refused 3 times going, and then 4th time he went. Can you name some of the local intelligentsia leaders who supported Gandhi in this Satyagraha? Apart from Rajkumar Sitla, any local people who were the leaders there?
Sorry, it's okay.
So, what do you see? Whether this Champaran Satyagraha was successful?
Yes, I was.
Till how much in the scale? It had supported peasants?
Yes, sir. The demand was to waive off the debts on the peasants. And since not all debts were waived off, but it was finalized that those who are willing to pay can pay, and those who are not, they were they were exempted from that.
Okay, from Chabaran he moved to Thera and Ahmedabad. He is always blamed, I am talking about Gandhi. Gandhi is always blamed for being a intermediary, that he is a subcontractor. Okay, he was not a leader, he was a subcontractor, some people say. So what do you think in the first initial three Satyagraha, Champaran, Thera and Ahmedabad, how much Gandhi was successful?
As you said, he's understood by many as intermediary. I think that is not a very good way to analyze him, because at that time the need was to provide a way to let the grievances of the common people be addressed at the national level, at the mass level, and as well as to the then ruling government.
So do you know about Sahajanand Saraswati?
Yes,
Swami Sahajanand Saraswati?
Yes, sir.
So you have been from Patna, hai na? Patna mein rahe hain aap. So do you know what was his ashram name? Where was he living in Bihar? It is very near to Patna, Bihta Ashram. Have you heard this word, Bihta?
Yes, sir.
He was living in the Bihta Ashram. So once upon a time in the 1930s, there was a flood and earthquake in Bihar. And Sahajanand had met Gandhiji to support peasants. Okay, Gandhi in that year was in Bihar. So do you know that incident between these two persons? What was his idea on Gandhi? Sahajanand Saraswati? No idea? Okay. You know about 1942 Quit India Movement?
Mm. Hmm.
In that, Sahajanand Saraswati had not participated. Why? Can you tell me reason? Have you read about Sahajanand Saraswati somewhere?
No, sir.
You have not read about him? All right. So, about the freedom struggle, we know about Subhash Chandra Bose. Hmm. So, what were the differences of opinion between two, Gandhi and Bose?
First of all, on the role of women, I think that Bose has more of a very broad view, and he even wanted to have women in the army, and he had that in his own
What was ideological differences?
So in the ideological differences, Gandhi believed in the sense of justice of the British rule at that time. But when compared to Gandhi, Subhash Bose...
Are you sure Gandhi believed in the British sense of justice by this time? The differences ho rahe the?
No, sir, not by that time. But when it came to the comparison between fascism and imperialism, Gandhi was surely against the rule, colonial rule, but he felt at that time that fascism is more dangerous for the world as a whole, as compared to...
But the differences happened before this idea, fascism. Gandhi, especially Subhash, met Hitler in 1941.
Mm-hmm.
But before the differences happened in 1939. Yes. That was not. Can you tell me what was the main reason behind the partition of India? Two, three important reasons, most important reasons.
Yes, sir. So the communal trends in the freedom struggle, which began from the emergence of Hindu extremist groups as well as Muslim League, that was the main reason. And later on, that divide was further utilized by the colonial power to keep that society divided. And that was the...
All right. Let us go to Simla conference. Na? In that Simla conference, Jinnah had told that he represents Muslim community solely. And he had blamed INC as a communal. So, what will your argument on the counter to this Jinnah statement? That INC was not a part of Hindu organization, it was a secular organization. What is your comment?
So, sir, in the main group of leaders of the INC, we find people from many sections, such as Maulana Azad was himself a Muslim, but he was in favor of this United India, and he was not orthodox. And even people like Abdul Ghaffar Khan, he also was...
And Maulana Abul Kalam was himself a president at that time, INC president.
Yes, sir.
He was a president from 1939 to 47.
Yes, sir.
So, that should be on. Okay. About a current affair, do you read regular newspaper?
Yes, I tried.
Okay,
to.
No?
No, sir.
So, about the UNESCO World Heritage Site, how many sites have been included in the UNESCO World Heritage Sites from Bihar?
So, currently there are two such sites. First one is the Mahabodhi Temple of Bodh Gaya, And the second one is the Nalanda University.
If you are made a secretary of the cultural department in Bihar, and you have to promote once more site for the UNESCO World Heritage Site, so what will be your choice?
So, my preference would be to utilize the Buddhist circuit, and in that sense, I think Bodh Gaya has already sufficient attraction from the tourists. The Kesariya Stupa, which is in Ariraj, which is near to Motihari itself, so that is the world's largest stupa, and I think that it has not gained that much attraction which it deserves. And the reason why I'm focusing on Buddhist place is because it is going to attract foreign tourists, which are high-end tourists, and that will add to the state's economy.
All right, that's nice. And one more site is there in Bihar, which is in Rajgir, and the state government wants to get the recognition of World Heritage Site. What is the monument name or place name?
Sorry, sir.
It's a wall prepared in Rajgir by the Haryana dynasty. Okay, so that is one. All right. So, can you tell me something about the UNESCO World Heritage Sites? UNESCO Heritage Sites have been named to some temples in India last year. There are 3 temples who have been recognized as a UNESCO World Heritage Sites.
Yes, sir. So there was one from Karnataka, Ranganath Swami Temple.
Three from Karnataka, 3 temples.
So first one was Ranganath Swami Temple. Rest two, I can.
That is the wrong. Okay, Chennai Kesab Temple hai, na? All right. Alone, last question is related to what was the challenges Bihar government was facing after independence?
Post independence. In the colonial rule, what happened that the administration's focus in that region was not on the health and education. They were more comfortable in the fact that people there are focusing on the farming or they are downtrodden, because that was beneficial for their own rule. And that is why, since the colonial rule itself, that region of Bihar, Bengal, that was neglected in terms of education, health, etc. So after independence, the main challenge was to address the poor population resource and the lack of infrastructure in terms of education, health. These.
All right. So are you aware about the zamindari in Motihari?
Yes, sir.
Who are the main zamindars? Can we recall some name?
Sorry, sir. I can't recall exact names.
All right. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Deepthi.
Thank you, sir.
Your mock interview is over.
Thank you,
sir. I take you back to the waiting room for a while. Okay. We'll call you back for the feedback. Huh? Come on. Welcome, Deepthi. So, if I ask you to rate your own assessment about today's interview.
So, it was a bit better from my last time, because last time was very...
When is your interview, by the way?
So, it's on 8th March.
8th March. Okay. Mm. How many mock interviews you have given?
This is my second one.
Second? Very good. So how many more you wish to give?
So I don't know, depends on
okay.
Your feedback.
Okay, let me start. We have had consultations among ourselves, and there are a few points. I'll start from the positive points which you have got. You have got excellent communication skill. Articulation is very good, very, very impressive. And in fact, I would say that you are the owner of a very good personality. Keep it up. No?
Thank you, sir.
Smiling face, honesty of answer, they are your strength. These are the positive points. Now, a few points don't get... I would like to share with you a few points, sir, which you must keep in mind so as to improve your performance further. First thing, when you entered, there is no need in the UPSC to seek the permission of the board for entry into the chamber. There is no need for that. In fact, they are as far as this. So you will not be heard also. And they are aware that you are coming. There will be an attendant who will be ushering you inside the chamber. So at best, you can give a gentle knock. That's enough. And don't say, may I come inside and all that. That's not needed. Huh? That's number one. And... you did not greet us the way we expected, you know. Please greet the chair.
A bit more energetic.
you should have, you know, energy level is okay, but you should greet the chair and the members. Greet means good morning, sirs, like this. You did not do it. Do it very, thoda josh se baat kariye aap thoda, hai na? You are such a wonderful personality. So thoda josh laiye apne usme. Zor se boliye, good morning.
Agar usme koi female member hai, to madam ko pehle greet karo.
Nahi, I differ with you. No, I'll give you, let me complete this, you know. Mm-hmm. The custom, which I have worked in UPSC, so I know the system. Greet the chair. If the chairperson happens to be a woman, good morning, sirs. Good morning, madam. Chair se start kariya. Good morning, madam. If the chairperson is a female. Eh? And then if there is another member who is a lady member, look at her. Don't. There is no individual salutations. You don't have to greet them individually. Good morning, good morning, good morning. No, it's only once. Good morning, madam. If it happens to be a chairperson. And then look at the other lady member also. Look at her, don't greet her. And then good morning, sirs. Reversely, if the chairperson happens to be a male, then good morning, sirs, plural. And look at the chairperson and look at all the male members. And then the lady member, if there is any. Theek hai? Abhi to lady members kafi hai, so it's quite possible that you may get a lady chairman. तो ये आप ध्यान में रखिएगा. आपने ग्रीटिंग नहीं किया हमको, दैट इज वेरी सीरियस ब्लंडर यू कमिटेड. प्लीज डोंट फॉरगेट दैट इन द एक्चुअल इंटरव्यू. एंड यू टुक सीट विदाउट आवर आस्किंग यू, दैट इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग. इज नॉट ए प्रॉपर इंटरव्यू एटिकेट. यू हैव टू जस्ट कम एंड टेक द शॉर्टेस्ट पॉसिबल रूट, स्टैंड बाय द साइड ऑफ द चेयर, देन लुक एट अस, लुक एट द चेयरपर्सन. आपको बोलेंगे वो टेक योर सीट, देन ओनली सिट. बट डोंट वेट एंडलेसली, वेट फॉर 3-4 सेकेंड्स. इफ दे डोंट आस्क यू, समटाइम्स यू नो दे डोंट आस्क यू, दे वॉन्ट टू सी योर स्ट्रेस लेवल, वेदर यू आर गेटिंग स्ट्रेस्ड आउट, वेदर यू आर नर्वस. दे विल नॉट आस्क यू फॉर 4-5 सेकेंड्स. डोंट गेट नर्वस, इट्स अ पार्ट ऑफ द इंटरव्यू असेसमेंट, इट्स अ पार्ट ऑफ द इंटरव्यू. सो यू सीक द परमिशन ऑफ द चेयर, मे आई सिट, मे आई हैव द सीट, ऐसा पूछ के बैठिए. बट बिना कहे अब मत बैठिए, याद रखिएगा, है ना? क्योंकि चेयरपर्सन का वीमेन हो, मेल हो, जो भी हो, वो आप याद रखिएगा. एंड योर आंसर, हैंड क्लास्पिंग वर ऑलवेज ऑलवेज यू आर सिटिंग लाइक दिस, दिस इज ए साइन ऑफ नर्वसनेस.
समटाइम्स ही आल्सो मूव्ड हैंड,
दादा मत मूव करी, थोड़ा बहुत अनकॉन्शियसली हो जाता है, ठीक है, बट डोंट मूव योर हैंड, डोंट स्पीक विद योर हैंड स्टैटिक. You have got such an excellent conversational ability. Speak with your hand. Don't speak with your hand. Move ज़्यादा मत करिए. थोड़ा बहुत unconsciously हो जाता है तो that is चलता है. लेकिन otherwise don't move your hand and don't clasp your hand like this. Keep your hands on thighs. That is the proper. That shows how much confident you are. अगर आप ऐसे करेंगे तो ऐसा लगता है आप nervous हैं. ठीक है? Which you are not. ठीक है? Your answers at times are very long. Please shorten your answers. Long answers are not appreciated by the UPSC. Yaad rakhiyega. You have to give very focused answer. Listen to the question very carefully. Theek hai? Pehle aap dhyan se suniye ki kya question pucha gaya hai. So that you don't go astray. Agar aap dhyan se sunenge to pata lagega kya pucha gaya hai. Then don't be in a hurry to answer back. वेट फॉर 2-3-4 सेकेंड्स. उसके बारे में सोचिए क्या क्वेश्चन पूछा और आपको क्या जवाब देना है. तो 3-4 सेकेंड में आप परमिसिबल है. ये कोई ऐसा ज़रूरी नहीं है, इट डज नॉट रिफ्लेक्ट गुड ऑन यू दैट यू इमीजिएटली जंप टू आंसर द क्वेश्चंस. ऐसा नहीं, थोड़ा 3-4 सेकेंड सोचना बहुत ज़रूरी है. यू शुड लुक लाइक ए थिंकिंग पर्सन. बोर्ड शुड नो दैट यू आर थिंकिंग एंड यू आर कमिटेड, यू आर सीरियस. थोड़ा सोचने का नाटक भी करिए. अगर आपको आंसर आता भी है, थोड़ा नाटक करिए उसको. ठीक है? एंड देन यू से फॉर्मुलेट योर व्यूज. 3-4 सेकंड में आप अपने व्यूज फॉर्मुलेट करिए, क्या क्या आपको बोलना है, कुछ की वर्ड्स रिकॉल करिए. और अगर आपको नहीं आ रहा है, अगर आपको आंसर नहीं आ रहा है, जस्ट से आई एम सॉरी सर, आई डोंट नो द आंसर्स. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. डोंट ब्लफ द इंटरव्यू. ब्लफिंग इज प्रोहिबिटेड इन यूपीएससी इंटरव्यू. ऑनेस्टी इज अप्रिशिएटेड. ठीक है? क्रिस्पनेस, फोकस्ड आंसर्स आर अप्रिशिएटेड. तो आप ये याद रखिएगा. योर कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल इज अगेन, आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू, वेरी गुड, एक्सीलेंट. and your conceptual clarity also is quite high. You are conceptually very clear about your your content, you know. Or I have some problem with your dress code, you know. There is no fixed dress code for the UPSC interview, but you will wear this dress.
No, sir.
What kind of dress will you wear?
Sir,
I normally refrain from advising ladies about their dress, but it is my duty to tell you, black color is not a good color for the interview.
Yes, sir. It's not the final.
It's not the. So you will wear sari.
Yes, sir.
And light
sir,
color sari.
Yes, sir, light color.
Off white will be better with small border. ठीक है ना? Off white कर लीजिए. Silk cotton sari कर लीजिए तो अच्छी रहती है. Not silk. Silk cotton sari is always admired. That is what I have been watching in UPSC. They have been wearing only silk cotton sari. अच्छा एक आप सर ने भी बोला है और इन सर ने भी बोला है एक आपका इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस आपका IFS इज नंबर सेकंड चॉइस ना तो थोड़ा इसको रिफ्रेश कर लीजिए. रीड योर रीड द न्यूज़पेपर्स इन इंग्लिश जो भी आपका है कौन कौन से न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ती हैं इंडियन एक्सप्रेस हिंदू जो भी आप पढ़िए जितना पढ़ सकती हैं डेली पढ़िए और जिस दिन आप जा रही हैं इंटरव्यू के लिए उस दिन तो जरूर पढ़िए हेडलाइंस पढ़िए उस दिन ठीक है. कीप योरसेल्फ फुल्ली अब्रेस्ट विद द लेटेस्ट डेवलपमेंट्स इन द इंटरनेशनल फर्मामेंट दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड आई कॉन्टैक्ट वॉज नॉट देयर आपका आई कॉन्टैक्ट जो था ना इट वॉज फिक्स टू ओनली वन पर्सन. Supposing sir asked you one question, you were constantly looking at him, which is not correct. Look at others also. Fleeting glance, unko bhi dekhte jaiye. So involve them also. Otherwise, they will get bored, you know. Involve them. देखिए आप अपने दोस्तों के साथ बात करती हैं फ्रेंड्स के साथ बात करती हैं तो आप सबको अटेंशन देती हैं ना. एक से तो बात नहीं करती हैं. When there's a group of friends, then you talk to everybody, you look at everybody. ऐसे आपको यहाँ भी involve करना पड़ेगा. Fixed, some institute advise you because I am telling you out of often hands-on experience in UPSC. I have worked in UPSC, but many institutes advise differently. तो कम से कम आप उनको follow करिए जो यहाँ मैं बोल रहा हूँ आपको with hands-on experience से बोल रहा हूँ. And I have been mentoring sales service aspirants. तो उसको याद रखिए कि आपका इन्वॉल्व ऑल दी मेम्बर्स उनको एक ग्लास दीजिए उनको भी इन्वॉल्व करिए वो आपको वॉच कर रहे हैं. समटाइम्स दे डू व्हाट दे डू आई एम गिविंग यू दिस सिचुएशंस ऐसे लिखते रहेंगे आपको देखेंगे नहीं यू विल फील इग्नोर्ड कि ये क्या कर रहा है बट ही इज वॉचिंग यू ही इज हियरिंग यू योर रिस्पॉन्सेज वो वॉच भी कर रहा है वंस इन ए वे. तो ऐसा मत सोचिए कि वो आपके इतना ध्यान नहीं दे रहा. दे आर ऑल लुकिंग एट यू दे आर लुकिंग डाउन बट दे आर हियरिंग यू हियरिंग योर रिस्पॉन्सेज. तो इस तरह का आप आई कॉन्टैक्ट आई मेंशन MEA की और वेबसाइट्स है इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस में हमारा इंडिया का क्या स्टैंड है ऑन वेरियस इश्यूज उसके लिए आपको इंडिया का स्टैंड के लिए वेबसाइट्स एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स मिनिस्ट्री की वेबसाइट्स आप पढ़ लीजिए इवन अदरवाइज यू नो तो उस पर आप ध्यान दीजिए. और
MOE के वेबसाइट पे बहुत सारे स्टैंड है इंडिया के इंडिया यूक्रेन इजराइल का यूक्रेन और रशिया वॉर का इजराइल और फिलिस्तीन
क्या स्टैंड लिया इंडिया ने वही आप सपोर्ट करिए.
न्यूक्लियर डॉक्ट्रिन है हमारा रिवाइज न्यूक्लियर डॉक्ट्रिन
ठीक है. अच्छा सोशियो इकोनॉमिक पैरामीटर्स फॉर बिहार आपका मालूम होना चाहिए. कम फ्रॉम बिहार सोशियो इकोनॉमिक पैरामीटर्स एनालाइज करिए लिटरेसी रेट क्या है व्हाट आर द इविल प्रैक्टिसेस. Dowry is very female feticide is also common. Na, women empowerment is almost missing. So kya karenge? Supposing as a district magistrate, what action will you take to enhance women empowerment in Bihar? ये question पूछे जाते हैं. और generally जो questions होते हैं वो opinion based question पूछते हैं आपसे. They will not ask you when was the प्लासी का युद्ध कब हुआ था या ये क्या हुआ था ये क्या ऐसा नहीं पूछते. ओपिनियन क्या है आपकी एनालिसिस आपकी एनालिटिकल अप्रोच लॉजिकल अप्रोच वो देखी जाती है उस पर आप ध्यान दीजिएगा. एंड आई हैव मेंशन अबाउट योर ड्रेस कोड आई कॉन्टेक्ट. एक डेफ जो आपका है बहुत रिच डेफ है बहुत अच्छा डेफ है उसको आप ज़रा पढ़ लीजिए. हमने जो बताया है देखिए कोई सिलेबस नहीं होता इंटरव्यू का तो दे कैन आस्क यू एनी डैम थिंग बट more often than not they will ask you all questions will emanate from the deaf. So deaf ka aap study kar lijiye self analysis kar lijiye aap and talk with your friends in english. jab bhi aap apne peer group se jo bhi aapke aur bhi friends honge jo pass ho gaye तो उनके साथ आप इंटरेक्ट करिए, जितना कर सकती हैं, जितना इंग्लिश में बात कर सकती हैं उतना करिए, मॉक इंटरव्यूज एक दूसरे का करिए आप, दैट विल ऑल्सो हेल्प यू अ लॉट. और आपको, क्योंकि आप पहली दफ़े जा रही हैं तो आपको ड्रिल का भी, और मैं आई विल टेक द अपॉर्चुनिटी बिकॉज टाइम इज रनिंग आउट, आई विल स्टिल टेक द अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑफ एडवाइजिंग यू. देखिए, व्हेन यू एंटर द यूपीएससी प्रेमिसेस देयर इज अ सेंट्रल हॉल, दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड वेटिंग हॉल. आपको वहाँ यू विल बी आस्क्ड टू सिट देयर, देयर इज लॉट ऑफ कैंडिडेट सिटिंग ऑलरेडी इन दैट हॉल, तो डोंट फील नर्वस, दैट्स द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट पीरियड. उसमें आपको एक जो आपके सर्टिफिकेट्स आप ले जा रही हैं, ऑल दो सर्टिफिकेट्स विल बी वेरीफाइड बाई एन ऑफिशियल ऑफ द यूपीएससी, वो देखेगा ठीक ठाक है कि नहीं, वो कमी है कि नहीं, ठीक. उसके बाद वो आपको बताएंगे योर बोर्ड नंबर इज 1, 2, 3, 4, दे विल नॉट टेल यू द नेम ऑफ द चेयरपर्सन और मेम्बर्स, वो नहीं बोलेंगे. ऑल योर पर्सनल इफेक्ट्स, पर्सनल आर्टिकल्स लाइक योर रिंग, योर रिस्ट वॉच, योर मोबाइल, योर पेन पेंसिल, जो भी, ये आपसे निकाल लेंगे. है उसको एक कपबर्ड में रख देते हैं, पिजन होल में, आपको टोकन देंगे, उसको आप रख दीजिए. यू विल बी डाइवेस्टेड ऑफ ऑल दीज आर्टिकल्स फॉर मैरिट, यू आर नॉट मैरिट. मैरिट के लिए उन्होंने मंगलसूत्र को वो देखते हैं थोड़ा सा, ठीक है कहीं कोई ऑडियो वीडियो डिवाइस तो नहीं इसमें प्लांट कर रखी है, तो इसलिए वो ये सारी चीज़ एक्सरसाइज उसी के लिए हो जाते हैं. आफ्टर दैट व्हेन यू टर्न मैच्योर्स यू विल बी टेकन बाई attendant, he will take you and you will be made to sit outside the interview chamber. That is again a very difficult period, you know. You will feel very nervous. There will be butterflies in your stomach. Don't worry about it. It happens with everybody. It happened with me when I wrote the IAS in 1970. It happened with me. It happened with everybody. So, usme aapko, aap baithenge, aram se rahiye. Keep relaxed. God will help you because you are so intelligent and you are so meritorious. You have got an excellent badge, Ata. तो आपको इसमें आना है. आप उसके बाद वो जो है, he will open the door for you when the bell comes and then you can, अगर knock देना तो दे दीजिए, otherwise they know that you are coming. अच्छा, you must know that the board does not have the marks attained by you in the written examinations. ये कहीं नहीं होता है, ठीक है. सो दैट दे डोंट गेट प्रेजुडिस, मार्क्स उनके पास नहीं होते. उनके पास एक समरी शीट होती है जिसमें आपकी सारी डिटेल्स, ये भी डेफ भी नहीं होगा, उसमें समरी ऑफ डिटेल्स होती है जिसके बूते पर वो चेयरमैन विल आस्क यू. समटाइम्स दे गिव यू वेरी ट्रिकी सिचुएशंस. आप देखिए, कोई ट्रिकी, कोई आपको सिनेरियो बता दिया, ऐसा है, सपोजिंग देर इज ए, यू मस्ट नो अबाउट एज ए, वॉट एक्शन विल यू टेक टू एम्पावर वीमन एज ए डिस्ट्रिक्ट मजिस्ट्रेट. सपोजिंग देर इज ए लेडी वर्किंग यू आर द डीएम and she comes crying to you that so and so colleague has misbehaved. So usme aapko kya karna hai, are you aware of the Vishakha guidelines? Wo padh lijiye zarur, kya hai uska committee approach, kya hai committee ka composition, is very important. Very often they ask you, ye sari cheeze aapko pata honi chahiye. Usme ek sociologist, social activist zarur hona chahiye, theek hai. Aur keep हेल्थ, 8 मार्च है ना, आप घबराइए मत, अपने हेल्थ को ठीक रखिए.
दैट इज वुमेन्स डे,
ठीक है. वन वुमेन हैज टू बी देयर, ठीक है. और कीप योरसेल्फ फुल्ली हाइड्रेटेड, फ्रूट लीजिए एज मच एज पॉसिबल. आजकल तो सर्दी है तो 8 मार्च तक हो सकता है गर्मी हो जाए, बट आई थिंक यू विल स्टिल रिक्वायर ए कार्डिगन, तो आप जरूर पहनेगा मैचिंग कार्डिगन. अगर नहीं पहनना चाहती तो कोई बात नहीं है. और टेक अनुलोम विलोम जिससे आपका फोकस अच्छा होगा. यू शुड हैव एनफ ऑक्सीजन इन योर ब्रेन सो दैट इट कीप्स फंक्शनिंग, यू नो, यू डोंट गेट नर्वस. दीज आर ऑल स्मॉल थिंग्स विच नो अदर इंस्टीट्यूट विल टेल यू. आई एम टेलिंग यू बिकॉज आई हैव एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ. तो ये आप ध्यान रखिएगा मेरे, और यू हैव गॉट ए स्माइलिंग फेस, दैट इज योर स्ट्रेंथ. हमेशा कीप स्माइलिंग, इवन इफ यू डोंट नो द आंसर्स. आई नो ऑफ ए कैंडिडेट, शी वॉज माई स्टूडेंट 3-4 years बैक, लेडी. She was smiling. She could not answer first question, second question, third questions, but she had a hearty laughter, not smiling but hearty laughter, and that was her plus point. See how kitna casual nahi hai. See, she is serious, but she is laughing at herself. That's a great quality, and she got very good marks. So keep smiling all the time. Don't laugh heartily, but keep smiling always. If you don't know the answer, smile. And say, sir, I'm sorry, I do not know. Again, देखिए, आपकी नॉलेज बेस तो ऑलरेडी टेस्ट हो चुकी है, अब उस पर आप कर रहे हैं, अगर आपको आंसर नहीं आता है तो फॉरगेट अबाउट इट. अगर हाउ इफेक्टिवली यू प्रेजेंट योर आंसर, दैट इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. ठीक है, ये चीज़ें आप ध्यान में रखिएगा. यू विल सर्टनली डू वेल एंड आई मस्ट वी हैव हाई होप्स फॉर यू एंड वी विश यू ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट इन द इंटरव्यू. ज़्यादा मॉक मत दीजिए, वो कन्फ्लिक्टिंग ओपिनियन होते हैं तो फिर में कन्फ्यूजन हो जाता है. ठीक है, एनी डाउट?
Anything that you want to ask from us? Any doubt that you are moving your mind? कि ओके ऐसा क्वेश्चन होगा तो क्या जवाब देना है भाई? एक पता नहीं कि बहुत सारे दोस्त भी आपको धमका देते हैं. अच्छा बोर्ड में जाओगे ये क्वेश्चन पूछेगा तो क्या करोगे? कुछ नहीं anything of. So if you want to ask any question, any type of doubt if you have, you may ask us.
बहुत अच्छा है आपका voice. वॉइस अच्छा है, मोनोटोनस भी नहीं है. वॉइस मॉड्यूलेशन मॉड्यूलेट करना चाहती हैं तो करिए तो अच्छा रहेगा. अगर मॉड्यूलेट का भी रास्ता करना या कुछ ऐसा करिए, मॉड्यूलेट करिए वॉइस को, तो इट विल ऐड वैल्यू टू योर पर्सनालिटी.
टेक गुड स्लीप बिफोर द
वेरी साउंड स्लीप. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट सर हैज रेज्ड इट. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. 8 आवर्स स्लीप यू मस्ट हैव. साउंड स्लीप
एंड डोंट थिंक टू मच. या
डोंट वरी, थोड़ा बहुत अपना ब्रश अप कर दीजिए, नॉलेज अप टू डेट रखिए अपने आप को. दैट इज कंटेंपरेरी इश्यूज आर जनरली टच द पॉइंट.
सर जिसके बारे में बात कर रहे थे, गर्ल्स दैट सी गॉट 28th रैंक, दिव्या मिश्रा परहैप्स मस्ट बी टॉकिंग. ओके ओके, ऑल द बेस्ट.
हां बिल्कुल, ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट.
ऑल द बेस्ट.
ऑल द बेस्ट.
बहुत अच्छी.
यू विल डू वेल.
हां कंटिन्यू,
गिव अस द गुड न्यूज़.
श्योर,
थैंक यू.